Hello, my name is Thane Heins, president of Potential Difference, Inc. And today we're doing a update video on the Bi-Toroid transformer. So the Bi-Toroid transformer is a new type of transformer that uses purely reactive power in the primary, but delivers real power to the loads. And here we have the output of the transformer. Can you come in and just so people can see that? Here we have the voltage across our two light bulbs and the current flowing through our two light bulbs, which indicates there's power being sent to these purely resistive loads. And our power factor on the primary of our transformer is zero. It's fluctuating. It's obviously not one. And down here we have the current and voltage sine wave. The red sine wave is the power sine wave, and this shows that the power that's coming in on one cycle is being returned back to the source on the other cycle, and the voltage and current are 90 degrees out of phase, which means that the power factor of our primary is zero, and all of the power that's being consumed in the primary is reactive power, meaning the net consumption is zero. So here we have the Bi-Toroid transformer with the primary in the middle. We have secondary one and secondary two. Right now, the two secondary coils are on load, and the secondary induced flux from secondary one travels into secondary two in this direction, and secondary two does the same thing. There's no flux, no secondary induced flux coupling back through the primary, and this is why the power factor of the primary is zero. And so when we put the Bi-Toroid transformer on no load, nothing changes. Or rather, when we put the Bi-Toroid transformer on load from no load, there's absolutely no change in the input to the primary of the Bi-Toroid transformer, and because there's no secondary flux coupling back through the primary affecting the performance of the primary from no load to on load. So we're going to compare this performance to a conventional transformer, which mirrors the load power factor in the primary. So when we put the conventional transformer on load, we will see a very different power factor. So here we have the conventional transformer is on load. The power factor in the primary, the power factor, can you just show the light bulbs again? The power factor of the load is one. That's transferred back to the primary of the conventional transformer, and it's reflected in the primary. So now we have the voltage in the primary times the current in the primary times one, and we have real power being consumed in the primary of our conventional transformer and real power being delivered to the load. And if we look at the sine wave, we can verify what the meter says, where the current and voltage are now in phase. the power sine wave is all above the middle line, denoting that all of the power that's being consumed in the primary is real power and that the power factor is 1. So now I'll put it back on the bit again so we can have a quick check here. So there's our bit on no load, on load again. Sorry, we have power flowing to our loads. The power factor in the bit is 0, and you can excuse that that meter fluctuating. That's the grid voltage which is causing the that power factor to jump to 1, but it's obviously not 1. So we're using this meter in conjunction with the oscilloscope to confirm that that both meters are saying the same thing, and in fact they are. So the conventional transformer, when it's on no load, it's consuming reactive power. When it's placed on load, the primary then consumes real power and delivers real power. The Bi-Toroid transformer, on the other hand, when it's on no load, it's consuming reactive power, and reactive power means that pure reactive power has a 0 power factor, and this is what we have in the Bi-Toroid transformer on no load. And then when we place it on load, there's absolutely no change. We are now sending power to our load, and the primary of the Bi-Toroid transformer is completely unaffected. So to go over just a little bit of transformer basics for you, here we have the conventional transformer that is on no load. There's no load connected to the secondary. The primary delivers flux to the secondary and induces a voltage in the secondary. The primary voltage and current are 90 degrees out of phase. That means the cosine of 90 degrees is 0, and the power in the primary is the voltage times the current times the 0, which is 0 watts. The power in the primary is evenly distributed, equally on the top and on the bottom, and this indicates that the incoming power on one half of the cycle is being returned on the other half. When the conventional transformer is placed on load, two very important things occur. First of all, the secondary coil of the transformer has current flowing in it, and it induces a flux which couples back through the primary. This magnetic flux lowers the impedance of the primary and causes the primary current to increase. And the other important performance feature of a conventional transformer is the load power factor, and in this case a load power factor of 1, is transferred back to the primary. So when the conventional transformer is on load, the voltage and the current are in phase, and the power consumed in the transformer is real power, and it has a real cost associated with it. Now, the Bi-Toroid transformer is very different in its operation. On no load, here we have a Bi-Toroid transformer that's on load, but on no load, the primary delivers its flux to both of the coils simultaneously. When secondary 1 and secondary 2 are placed on load, the induced flux from secondary 1 does not go through the primary. It travels in this direction through secondary 2, in this direction through secondary 2, and secondary 2 does the same thing. So we have zero flux coupling back through the primary, and this means that the load power factor cannot be transferred back to the primary, and the current in the primary does not go up when the bi-toroid transformer is placed on load, because it's only the secondary flux when coupling back into the primary that can change the performance of the primary from no load to on load. In the bi-toroid transformer, because there is no secondary flux in the primary, the voltage and current are 90 degrees out of phase, and the net power in the primary is zero, and the bi-toroid transformer uses pure reactive power in the primary but delivers real power to the loads, whereas the conventional transformer uses real power in the primary and delivers real power to the secondaries, to the load, from the secondary to the load. And the bi-toroid transformer, again, on the other hand, uses reactive power with a net power consumption of 0 watts. All for now. Thank you very much.